Okay, so we also have shielding for the room. Most of these walls are lined with concrete, okay? Some of the walls are thicker than others. If you come right over this way, you can see how this wall juts out. This wall is 6 foot thick solid concrete all the way back. When you get to this wall, it's 3 foot thick concrete. So you can see it's twice as thick right here. What this is this, if you had the machine on its side pointing this way, this is as much as you could treat with the field size as large as it will go, which is 40 by 40, okay? So that's the primary shielding. We have primary shielding and secondary shielding, okay? We also have the maze. As we come right through here, you can see there's this hallway and then our radiation therapy treatment door. In order to reduce the amount of shielding needed on the door, we have this thickness of concrete right here. So you have to walk down walk down this hallway and back into the treatment room. The maze is between us and the beam, and it's not within the primary direction of the beam either. What it does is you have turns and twists and a thick wall that allows you to not have as thick of a door. Okay? If you did not have a maze, this door would be about 3 times thicker than this. So as we come out to the treatment console, which is a little bit further out and around another corner, it's kind of a mess right now, but you can see right here we have our bank of computers, we have a record and verify system, the actual varying unit. Okay, in your illustration you saw that this is our readout where everything takes place. So this is where you can program the machine to tell it how many MU to give the patient, our field size, collimator, gantry. See how this kind of mirrors what is inside the room on the pizza board. Okay, gives you all kinds of other information as well, but this is where you will actually do the real programming with the keyboard that will allow this to happen. This is the varying keyboard, collimator, field size, gantry, all of the same things keep getting mirrored around. You have a key lockout and a beam on button, a beam off button, an emergency off button. We have some secondary computers here for imaging. And we also have an audio monitor. We have cameras in place. We can always see and hear our patient at all times. Okay, we have the modulator is inside the treatment room. This is one of the other computer banks that you have on your handout and various other CPUs. On this particular unit, we have imaging, we have a KV imager, and we're able to do KVs and cone beams, which we will discuss at a later date.